CIET-NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 1.
Hello lovely kids, how are you all today? What are you up to? I hope you all are happy and enjoying. I am Kirti Yadav and I am a teacher. Today, I want to learn a few new things with you all. Are you ready to come with me and to join this joyous learning? Yes, of course, you all will be having fun with me in this way. Let's come with me and find it very interesting to learn new things. Today, I'll take your Maths Magics, that mean your Mathematics, Chapter 1, Shapes and Space, and our topic is Rolling and Sliding. You all like listening story, na? Yes. Am I right? I like it too. Yes. Everyone likes to listen stories. Today, I will narrate a very interesting story that you all can enjoy and have fun with me. The name of the story is The Wise Grandmother. So, let's come and have fun. The Wise Grandmother. Here, there was a lamb. Lamb is walking on the road all alone. And in the sides of the road, there are so many trees. The lamb was going to see his grandmother. On the way through the jungle, he met a wolf. The wolf said, "I am going to eat you today. I am going to eat you today. I am going to eat you today." The lamb was so scared of listening this. The lamb was just very, very scared. Then lamb said, "Please let me go. Please let me go. I am going to meet my grandmother. Please let me go. You can eat me when I return. Oh, please let me go now." Then the wolf was seated there and said, "Okay, you can go." Then the lamb went to meet his grandmother and met his grandmother. They enjoyed being in each other's company. They had food together. Now, lamb thought of returning. When lamb was about to return, he told his grandmother about the wolf. He told his grandmother that while he was coming there to meet her, the wolf said he wanted to eat him. Grandmother was panicked. "Why he wanted to eat you? Why he wanted to eat you?" Then grandmother started thinking for some time and then she gave an idea. Grandmother said, "You can use a dholak and you can hide yourself in the dholak." Lamb was wondering, "How can I hide myself in the dholak, grandma?" Then grandma said, "Oh, you can sit in a dholak. I'll put the lid of the dholak and then I'll roll the dholak on the road." "Oh ho, what you are saying, grandma? Is it feasible to sit in a dholak?" Grandma said, "Oh yeah, you can do this." But as grandmother said, he hid himself in the dholak. Now the grandmother rolled the dholak on the road. Grandmother rolled the dholak on the road. Can you imagine the lamb? Who is in the dholak? When grandmother rolled the dholak started rolling. The lamb saw the wolf waiting for him. The lamb was scared again. He was thinking, what should I do now? The wolf will catch me. What will I do now? The wolf was waiting for lamb patiently. After seeing the dholak, wolf asked the lamb, who is inside the dholak? Did you see a lamb coming this way? Then the lamb from inside said, no, I did not see anyone. Now, dholak again started rolling. After seeing this, the wolf grew suspicious and started running behind the dholak. And he was just running behind the dholak. Now, lamb sensed that the wolf is following him. Before the wolf could catch him, the lamb reached home and was thankful to his mother. Isn't it great? Yes. Ideas of grandmother saved lamb's life. Your elder ones are also giving you some wise advices, na? Yes, mine are giving. So, they might be helping you all. Let's have a gratitude for them. Today, you can thanks everyone who have helped you in any way. Now, who will tell me what we have learned in this story? There is very interesting idea that grandmother gave to the lamb. That is rolling in the dholak. Have you ever rolled in the dholak? I haven't. What it means to roll? Can you all tell me what it means to roll? Can you all guess what it means to roll? Let me tell you all. Rolling means to move smoothly. The way dholak moved on the road? Yes, you all get it right. Rolling is to move by turning over and over and over. So, I am giving here a few examples, that is, like you all play with the ball. Like football. Football also rolls very smoothly on the floor. Like the apples fell out of the bag and rolled everywhere. Sometimes the car begins to roll back down the hills. You all must have understood the rolling. Am I right? Now tell me, kids, what is there if there is a box? Can a box too rolls? Can a dice rolls? This we have to think about. No, a box, a dice, a geometry box, they can't roll. So what they do? For all these answers, I want you all to open your Math Magic book and open page number 12. And those who doesn't have book, they need not to worry. I will explain each picture one by one. So, here two similar pictures are given on this page. In the first picture, three friends are playing with some objects and there is a slide also. One kid is sitting on the top and he is sliding down a ball from the top. So what will happen to the ball? What will happen to the ball? Tell me. Yes, the ball will come down by rolling. So any object which is circular or round shape, they are called rolling objects. That means they rolls. In other picture, three children are playing. One slide is also there and a girl is sitting on the top. But here is sliding a box. So how can a box roll? I just asked you, can a box rolls? No. Then what will happen to the box? The box will slide as box is having a smooth surface. That means a plain surface. So now you can ask me, what is sliding, ma'am? I'll let you know. Sliding is to move or make something move smoothly along a surface. Now we all get to know about rolling and sliding. Here, in the page number 16, few objects are given. Let me tell you all. In the first row, there is pencil, football, matchstick, and onion. And they are asking us to tick the objects that will roll. Here, tell me kids, which object will roll? I have just told you. Think about it. You can answer it. I'm giving you 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. I hope you have got the answer. Let me help you in this. Pencil, football, and onion will roll. They have also given another picture in this page. Let me tell you about this picture. In this picture, they are asking us to tick the objects that will slide. And the objects are as bottle gourd, tomato, briefcase, and a battery. So can you tell which object will slide? Can a tomato slide? No, a tomato is a rolling object. Can a bottle gourd slide? Bottle gourd is also a rolling object. Can a battery slide? No, battery is also a rolling object. So which one is left? You can answer this. Which one is left? Briefcase. Yes, briefcase is the sliding object. You all have got to know which objects are sliding and which objects are rolling. Now let me tell you, what is sliding? It is the only object which is having a plane surface. That is why we said briefcase is the sliding object. So kids, you have learned so many things. That is how the object rolls, how the object slides, which object rolls, which object slides, and how can we segregate these objects, which is the sliding object and which is the rolling object. And we have done a very interesting story as well. That is the wise grandmother. So the wise grandmother story took us to the rolling objects. Now I want to tell you a few more things. I want to take you to learn a new words, that is nearer and farther. What is I am having in my hand is a potato, which is placed at some distance from me. So kids, can you tell me that which is near to me, a potato or a toy? Yes, you all are right. I know you are answering it right. Potato is nearer to me and toy is far to me. Now, those who are having books, they can open page number 6. And those who are not carrying their books and not having their books, they can imagine the picture as I will let you know. Here, a picture is given in which there is a home, a tree, which is just behind the home, and a tree which is just adjacent to the home, and there is greenery all around. Two birds are flying in the sky. As I told you, when there is less distance between two things, they are near to us, and when we have more distance between the things, they are far from us. In this picture, two birds are flying, which is just near to the home and which is far from the home. When we ask which one is nearer to the home, then the first bird will be nearer. Let me ask you a few questions. On this page number 6, they are asking, take the bird nearer to the home. Yes, you all are right. The first bird is nearer to the home. Let's do some activity based on this. What you all have to do, make a circle with chalk. You can use anything which is available in your home. And what you have to do with the chalk, you have to make a circle on the floor. Now, put a few things, like you can put your geometry box close to the outline of the circle and your crayons, pencil, sharpener just far from the outline of the circle. Here, you all can see which object of yours is near to the outline of the circle. Can you tell me this? It's so very easy. You yourself has put that object. Yes, you all are right. Your geometry box is placed near and crayons are far from the outline of the circle. Here, you can also tell me the nearer object. Yes, you all are right. I knew it. You can answer it. Your geometry box is nearer to the outline of the circle. As we get to know about near, far and nearer, can you all tell me which thing is nearer to you right now? Yeah, you have to answer this. Which thing is nearer to you right now? Let me tell you mine. To me, my mic is very nearer. Right, kids, you can also think about yours. You all must be answering. Let me tell you, a glass of water is also placed near to me. Very good. Think about yours. Which thing is near to you and which thing is far from you? Let's move to the another picture. Open page number 6 again and look at the picture. Those who doesn't carry the books, they can imagine it with me. In this picture, there is a one tree and three cats. One cat is sitting under the tree and one cat is away from the tree. And another cat is hiding behind the rock and watching the other two cats. Now, as we know, when anything, object, person, which is having the largest distance is called the farther one. So, I'll ask you and you can answer me. Take the cat farther from the tree. Can you answer this? Yes, you all are right. The cat which is hiding behind the rock is farther. Can you guess why the cat is behind him? She might be afraid of these two cats. Very good, kids. Now, we all can practice with some simple and interesting activities. Let me help you in this. You can use your crayons, pencils, anything which is easily available at your home. What you all have to do is scatter your crayons randomly around you. Now, tell me which color crayon is farther from you. Isn't it the interesting game? What you have to do? You have to take your crayons and you have to just scatter it all around. It can be of any color. Red, green, yellow, any color. It's so very interesting. I enjoyed a lot when I did this. You also enjoy. Let's have some game with your toys also. Ask your parent to help you out. What we have to do? You can place your toys at different place in corridor or in your room or any place in your home. Now, you have to see which toy of yours is farther from you. This you can do yourself also, and you can take help from your elder one too. I want you all to open your page number 7. And those who doesn't have books, again, you need not to worry. I'm here to help you out na. I'll let you know what is given in this picture. I'm here with you all to explain everything. In this picture, there is one tree in which a swing is attached with ropes. And a boy is running towards the swing. He was thinking, first I'll have the ride, first I'll swing on this swing. And he is near to the swing. One girl who is wearing pink clothes also running towards the swing. Another girl is also here who is carrying two balloons. One is of red color and another is of blue color. Also running towards the swing. Now, the boy is nearest to the swing and the girl in the pink clothes farthest from the swing. I'll let you know about another picture and you all will help me out in finding which is the farthest and the nearest. See the picture. Let me tell you about this picture. In this picture, one tree is given and four puppies are running towards the tree, one after another. So, you have to tick or tell me the puppy farthest from the tree. Yes, you are right. The last puppy is the farthest from the tree. In another picture, three trees are given and a bird is flying in the sky. So they are asking to which tree the bird is nearer. Now we have to tell that the bird is very near to the right tree. Now tell me, and you can also take in your book, the tree nearest to the bird. Now you have to tell me, and you have to take in your book also, the tree nearest to the bird. Yes, the tree in the right is the nearest to the bird. You all have understood nearer and farther, nearest and the farthest. Now, can you all imagine which thing is nearest to you and which thing is farthest to you? Can you touch the sky?
I am trying right now. Am I able to touch the sky?
I am not able to touch the sky. Is it near to me or farther from me? The sky is far from us. So which thing is close to us? Which thing is near to us? Which thing is nearest to us? Which thing is farthest to us? That we have done in this chapter, and you can do this in your book and you can just recall everything that I have told you. I hope you all have understood this very well. I'll come next time with so many interesting words. Till then, you all will stay indoors and keep yourself and your family safe. Bye bye. Thank you.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.